Roll in. About this. At the end of your mind, you do this as a special event. Next. Few are words of your life, right? Okay, I'm going to do 34. It's long, but not that hard. We have this function here. Goes from the second playlist on N to the same set. And it is defined by the following expression. We call that the definitional function in these two objects. The statement of the domain, the codomain, plus the expression, the written expression of the assignment. Is the empty list when the length is zero, when it is the empty list again, is L when it's just an element, and then we have an expression as the recursive rule. Okay, so question number one. Let's call this basic rule 1, basic rule 2, recursive rule 1, and we have to evaluate these two guys. Okay, so this the basic rule and the recursive rule depends on the length of the list. So this is length 0, length 1, and the rest of the cases. So this is recursive rule 1. What do I write here? Class. Yeah, so I know you know how to count in English, that's quite impressive. So this should be 3, 4, 5. Concatenation with 1. Do you agree on that? Yeah? So the rest is the rest of the rest. So the rest is from 2 to 5. And then the rest of the rest is from 3 to 5. Alright? This is length 3. So it's neither 0 nor 1. Have to carry on with my recursive rule. right is one thing. Watch out here is not three ones, but one three, right? So we should, sometimes, I don't know why, people apply the rule and start inserting things here. Please, yes? Apply the rule as it is. And finally, this is...
Basic rule.
And so many two. Yeah, because it says... So this is just five again, and it doesn't say put it at the end. Rules are rules. Okay, we will have to write it here.
Your question is related to the next
Question here, C. So, C, you are asked to define a function same domain and same codomain, and now we want the following. We have a list with an even number of elements. The value of that list is the same for both lists with an even and an odd number of elements. And the common value is the definition, right? It's a constraint. The common value is Spain that tell you how to ways to do this problem, either state a third basic rule or just write down the recursive rule. I think the former is easier for you. So if less of L is 2, say, what do I write here? According to the definition of G.
Yes. Direct.
What? Yeah, I'm getting the elements at the position, and I have a two element list, so it should be D.
A2?
B. Okay. According to that definition, if I have this, how do I write it here? That's the list walked by B, right? Somebody says it said A or B. Because here I was using subscripts and there was a, come on. It doesn't matter if I use letters or subscripts. There I had to use subscripts because I had too many elements, right? But here for A, B. So that should be B. And now my recursive. Yes?
Do you have the A2?
Here? So I have my list. Right? And I have, I don't know, 1, 2, 3, 0, 2. This is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6. And the function D is taking me that list into the following one. I remove those at the odd position, I just leave those at even position, which is 2, 3, and 2. So this is A2, A4, A6. So A2, A4, A6, blah, 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 A2, A2. And there you can be. So this is A1, A2, A2. As you wind me up. This happens to me a lot. Hard question, you get it. An easy question, you don't. And then I get confused. So if now I have a list of length greater than 2, what do I have to write here? And that's the core of that problem. So you are supposed to get inspiration from the previous example. A and B. So say something. Whatever. Okay, I'll give you a minute. I thought you had solved the problem before going to class, so everybody who have taken great advantage of this class. But as I may see, I was wrong.
Should we have F of the rest of that? And then
concatenation
with Calda and his other with the first part of the
okay. You said this concatenation. The hand of L. I've got the feeling that if you do that, you're going to put all the elements at the tail. Tail, you don't think? No, voila. Tail is also K. gara, when you toss a coin, tail or heads, right? Tail is also a cola de perrito, dog's tail. So you do that, you are going to put the first time you apply this book, you are going to put it at the tail. Now, you don't want what? You want to put it at the hand, right? So how do you solve that? If I want to keep, the first time I apply my Bicarbonate rule, I want to keep A2 at the hand. I have to apply F here, right? So following up with Christian's idea, that would be your idea, but correctly bad. Do you think this is completely correct? No, why? So, sorry, you talked at the same time. Christian, for example.
You got the first element.
Yeah, that's true. How do I solve it? So if I want to go every other two? Yeah. That's it. One more. That's the solution. Well, the rest of this is quite easy. Or it's more about it. It's enough. It's not new materials. I'm going to just keep it and leave it for you. So you have to go through it before the exam. So nice assimilation and digestion, and better vomiting on Friday. And now I'm going to do 25. Exercise 25. Functions does the following. This M, and this is the list. Okay, so okay, so here, That is example, right? Okay, good. Okay. So. Ah, yes.
Uno.
So, yes, yes, yes. Yeah, I guess it's something. Yes, yes, yes. I just forgot to write something. Yeah, can. You have this and you don't want to write can. You don't want to write this element. What's this element here? That's the hand of the rest. So sorry about that. This, I forgot to write the rest here. I was vomiting in that day when I read it. Okay, very nice. At least you caught it. You caught it. Nice. At least you caught it. So you're paying attention. No, I'm so proud. I'm really proud. Okay, more. So I was saying that this function finds every occurrence of n and replaces it by n plus n, right? So this is 3 plus 7, this is 3 plus 7, and this is 3 plus 7. And I want to define the function output in that.
Because otherwise,
it will be substituted by n plus n. Agreed? And now the recursive rule. So you have to think recursively. How can I solve this problem in terms of smaller problems? Here we have many solutions. I have at least three solutions, or maybe more. I'm going to ask you something. Suppose I cut that list into two pieces. If I solve the problem for this piece, and then I concatenate everything, and I solve that problem for this piece, and then I concatenate everything, we have I solved the problem. So that's thinking recursively. To translate this idea to the writing of the recursive rule. The easiest way is just to say, I'm going to solve the problem for this guy. This is a typical example where the recursive rule implies the use of two heads. Anytime you have head of something and then complementing with F or whatever, again you have two heads. So if you ask the dependency tree, that's like that. It's a binary tree because here you have two columns, right? And for the little things we're doing here, that's all right. We are taking just one element and the rest. But I could have taken half of the list, and it would have worked the same way, right? In fact. In actual programming, that's what we do. Because the complexity, the time complexity, is much lower that way. This type of recursion underlines the general methods, solving problem methods called divide and conquer. Divide and conquer. Okay. What else? for example, so I can tell you for sure that I'll be out from May 18th to May 21st. So we'll have to make a class for 3 hours, but we'll leave it after the exam. It's more logical. As for tomorrow, I'll come here. If you have doubts, that's all right. We'll review something. If you don't have doubts, I'll go back to my office.
Okay.
No, what? I'll bring that class at 1 o'clock.